have a maker. He formed my heart before even time began. My life was in his hand. He knows my name.
Are you ready? Okay. Okay, write that down first. After the fall of Adam, the Trinity God had a special committee for human salvation. They decided to send the Son of God, Jesus, to die on the cross, shedding his blood to show people, to show men that they need the blood of Jesus Christ to restore their life back. From that time on, the Lord Jesus with the name of Jehovah God in the Old Testament had appeared to many people, telling them what he is going to do. Later on the cross, the fall of Adam happened in BC 4114, BC 4114, okay? From there, it took Jesus, born of Jesus, and his crucifixion about 4,000 years from the fall all the way around 4,000 years here where Jesus was born. Everybody agree? Yeah? These 4,000 years period of time, he slowly had shown his plan of salvation slowly, gradually to human. This is what we call progressive revelation. Progressive revelation. Not showing his plan everything in detail from the beginning, from the moment of the fall of Adam. He did not tell fallen Adam that now I'm going to do it. I'm going to die on the cross. He did not do that. He just showed him very much in infancy level, spiritual infancy level. From that moment on, slowly revealed more in detail. So he started with the infant, spiritual infant level teaching. and later elementary school level teaching. Later middle school teaching level. Middle school. And high school level teaching. And later university level teaching to reveal his salvation plan. So it is progressively revealed. Not at one time. During those 4,000 years period. 4,000 years refers to 4 days in God's eyes. Where you find that reference? 1 day equals 1,000 years. Where in the Bible? Psalm 90 verse 4. 2 Peter 3, 8. Yeah. So actually in God's eyes, it took him for 4 days to reveal completely about himself. But in human eyes, how many years? For 4,000, about 4,000 years. The biblical number 4 means what? I told you many times. Biblical preparation period through trial, training, disciplining to achieve objective. Let me say again. Preparation period through what? Trial, discipline, training to what? Achieve objectives. What objective? What is the objective? Dying on the cross to fulfill what? To fulfill Genesis 3:15. What kind of trials and trainings? From here, from the time of Adam, Enoch time, now heavy training and trials during the Noah's time, Noah's flood. Later, Abraham, that is the beginning of the history of Israel. Here, through the history of Israelites, all kinds of trials were taking place. God sent them to Egypt for how many years? 400 years. And after that, delivered them out of the Egypt bondage. There are all these historical stories portrays what? The death of Jesus Christ and his resurrection. Are you with me? All these stories. So during the 4 days time, God has shown these people what he is going to do on the Calvary to fulfill that promise, Genesis 3:15. So these Old Testament stories, including the history of Israel, in one word, is what? That's the story for fulfilling the Genesis 3:15. So when you read Bible, Old Testament in particular, you have to have that perspective, that idea. And you interpret the Old Testament according to that direction. Then you are on the right track if you do that way. Why? Jesus said so. later. I gave you long time ago, about a couple of months ago, when we started this on the topic of Bible, of the Bible. Jesus said, you read, you search the scripture. All these scripture stories are about myself. Okay? Where in the Bible? John 1, chapter 5, 39. And we've got two more references. Two more. Luke chapter 24. Luke chapter 24. Open Bible. Find it up. Verse 27 and 44. Luke chapter 24, verse 27 says this. And the beginning with his Moses, with all the prophets, he explained to them the things concerning himself in all the scriptures. So all the scripture stories are story of who? Jesus Christ. And verse 44, same. He spoke to his disciples. The Moses and prophets and even Psalms, all those stories were concerning Jesus Christ. Subtitle called The Infancy Period. After the fall of Adam, Adam lost the eternal life. And he entered into the time period. He entered into the time. In other words, he used to be in eternity. After the fall, he lost the eternity, now transport himself down to the time period, meaning he's gaining age. Every day, he was getting older and older and older. And he discovered himself that he was naked, and so as his wife. When before the fall, the nakedness was not a shame. But after the fall, the nakedness was shameful. So his shame should be covered by the fig leaves. F-I-G, fig leaves. In Genesis chapter 3, verse 7, just to highlight that, the fig tree leaves. But after the grand plan of salvation, in Genesis 3:15, Jehovah God, Jesus, appeared to Adam and Eve and asked them to replace the fig leaves with the skirt of skin skirt in Genesis chapter 3 verse 21. Now they had a new type of skirt to cover their shame. You open your Bible again. You go to verse 21, chapter 3, and highlight that. You have that verse 21? Verse 21 says that the Lord God Jesus made garments of the skin for Adam and his wife and clothed them. So you highlight that part. Skin, the garments, skin, that is, it's a skirt. Now it changes from what to what? The fig leaves to skin. Okay. Okay, continue writing. Skin is the product of the animal killing. Without the killing animal, there will be no skin. The killing of animal requires the blood shedding to fulfill the Genesis 3:15, the seed of woman in a very infancy level. Very infancy level, Jesus required Adam to kill the animal, and that animal skin with the blood stain there, blood stain, skin with the blood there, okay? That blood skin will cover your shame. Which means the blood of Jesus will be the only instrument, only power, only skirt to cover your nakedness, your shame. It was a symbolic presentation of future, the blood of Jesus Christ. It was a very infancy level of the blood of Jesus Christ applying to them. This is what we call the plan number one. Plan number two. I just wrote it down here. The what? The Lamb of Abel. The first one, plan number one, was the Lamb of skirt. Lamb of the skirt. Okay? And the plan number two is the Lamb of Abel. Adam had two sons, Cain and Abel. And Cain was a farmer, and Abel was what? Flock keeper. Why don't you open your Bible, chapter 4, verse 2. You can highlight that. Highlight, Abel was a flock keeper. Cain was a tiller of ground, a farmer. You just highlight that. And verses 3 and 4, let me read it. So it came about in the course of time that Cain brought an offering to the Lord of the fruit of the ground. And Abel, on his part, also brought of the firstlings of his flock. Would you highlight that part? And their fat portions. The Lord was regarded for Abel and for his offerings. Adam commanded his two sons to worship Jehovah God through blood shedding offerings. But Cain just gave the Jehovah God his product, grain. But Abel followed his father's command. The issue over here is not the offering itself. God's concern is the offerings with the blood, blood included. Like the skin skirt, which had a blood there. Adam instructed his children, two sons, to offer animal to their God. But Cain did not take that seriously. He just offered what he had. He didn't pay much attention to the value of the blood of the animal. He thought whatever he has, he feels important, he just gave that to God. God was not pleased with that. Why? Because there was no blood involved. Some theologians said because God accepted Abel's offerings, because that was Abel gave God the firstborn, okay? Like that, but that's not. It has blood involved. Now, later, God accepted Abel's sacrifice as a righteous offering. And later in Hebrews chapter 11, let's open Hebrews chapter 11. So that has to be related to that, okay? Hebrews chapter 11. Let's see. That's the Hebrews chapter 11. Now, verse 4. Now, by faith, Abel offered to God a better sacrifice than Cain. Would you highlight that? By faith. You highlight that. That sentence alone gives us good indication. Now, then who had more faith than others amongst two? Abel had more faith than Cain. Would you write it down again? Okay, I'll give you logically. Abel had more faith than his brother, your older brother Cain here. Then, what kind of faith? What kind of faith? And write it down. What kind of faith, or what is faith? There. What faith now he's talking about? Then you write down the faith comes. Faith comes from hearing, right? And hearing what? The word of God. Okay, read. That's the important part. Faith comes from hearing of the word of God. Right? Don't forget that. Then here, his father Adam gave him the word of God. Gave them Cain and Abel, the word of God. Word of God of what? Sacrifice, blood involved sacrifice. That was his father's command. But his big brother Cain did not pay attention to that command because he did not have faith. The Lord did that, his father must have said this. If you offer that blood killing, blood related animal sacrifice, God will bless you. That promise. Okay? But Cain did not have faith in that promise. And Abel had a faith in the promise of Father. So, over here it said, Hebrews chapter 11, verse 4 said, by faith Abel offered to God a better sacrifice than Cain, through which he obtained the testimony that he was righteous. God testified about his gift through faith. Though he is dead, he still speaks. In other words, that by exercising faith, Abel became a righteous man before God. So up until here, plan number one and plan number two. Now, what is the major issue here? Blood. Okay? Blood. This plan number one and plan number two are considered the infancy period revelation of the grand plan of salvation. This is what I made it, okay? So just put down subtitle called Elementary School Period. There are two plans in this period. There are two plans in this period. Number one is plan number three. Plan number three called the genealogy of Adam and Adam to Noah in Genesis chapter 5. That is plan number three. The genealogy of Adam to Noah in Genesis chapter 5. And plan number four is the Lamb of Noah's Ark in Genesis 6:14. So these two plans, plan number three, plan number four, are the teachings and revelations of what? Elementary schools period. Okay, this plan number three and four are more developed and progressive revelation of the grand plan of salvation. It is just like students, elementary students, learning plus and minus and multiplications and divisions. In the beginning, plus and minus, mathematics, right? And a little later, multiplications, 2, 2, 4, 2, 3, 6, 2, like that. And divisions. Just write down everything what I'm saying here, okay? Now, in plan number 3, when there are 10 persons, names, recorded in chapter 5, Genesis chapter 5, beginning with Adam to Noah. Noah is the 10th descendant, 10th generation, number 10, 10th generation of Noah. The Lord Jesus, in the name of Jehovah God, gave each person the name in Hebrew language. In Hebrew language, when they were born, their names, their each name contains a special meaning. Special meaning in light of the grand plan of salvation. Their names involved the clear revelation of what the seed of woman will do in the future. Let us look at their names. Number one, Adam means in Hebrew man. Adam means man. Number two, Seth, the second Adam's son. Seth means appointed, appointed, or designated. Number three, Enos means mortal. Mortal means, you know, we are mortal man means, meaning that you destined to death. You supposed to die. We are mortal being, meaning that we supposed to die. What is opposite to that meaning? Immortal. Yeah, immortal means God is immortal. Okay? So meaning Enos means mortal. Number four, Canaan means sorrow. Number five, Mahalali means the blessed God. You know, El is God, right? It finishes with the El, Mahalal. It's that meaning is the blessed God. And number six, Zaret, shall come down. Number seven, Enoch.
예수님의 재림을 준비하는 영적 추수 사역에 일조하는 부부가 되기를 간절히 소원합니다.
주님. I want to hear the gospel in my language.
예수 그리스도와 면마비에 또 피바네 예수 हम सबकी निजात के लिए मर गया
क्रिस्ती ब्यामा का मनागे बाकुते नेया कुनु मरुदा ঈশ্বর আপনাদের ভালোবাসেন ঈশ্বরের পুত্র যীশু খ্রিস্ট আপনাদের জন্য মৃত্যুবরণ করেছিলেন
যেসু আইনি নিশাংসিং থা তে ইউ সেই ইয়েসিং চুফুন